you about taking risks. Now, how many of you have been told that it's really good to take a risk and step out of your comfort zone? Yeah, most of you have. It can be a little bit cliche, and I think people who say this often don't realize that it's a lot easier said than done to take any risks in your life. As I'm talking, I want you guys to think about this question. What's the bigger risk? Taking the risk or not taking the risk at all? So starting off at an early age, I was very outgoing and confident, and I always wanted to try new things. I was ready to go out there, meet new people, do whatever I wanted to do. But this picture kind of sums up what I'm like now. I'm kind of a little bit more nervous. I look like I'm stressed out all the time, but I get frustrated easily. And somewhere along the line, I became very shy and a lot more scared to try new things or step out of my comfort zone. Now fast forward to high school. This was a new time when I was entering a new school with a lot of new people, new experiences, and I was really excited about it, but at the same time, my shyness and the fact that I was a lot more introverted kind of prevented me from going out and doing everything I wanted to do, but I knew that I had to make some sort of change about it. So the next stage in my life, I decided to audition for the fall play for my high school theater company. Now, none of my friends were really into theater, so I knew I kind of had to do this on my own. There was no one who was going to be there with me to kind of support me along the way or help me out. But I ended up going there, and I met some new people, and it ended up going okay, but I didn't get the part. And I didn't get any part at all, actually, which was a little bit upsetting, but at the same time, I decided I still want to get involved with this, so I ended up joining the art group for the theater company. And although I failed with what I originally intended to do, by taking that initial risk, that led me to doing something even more bigger and better. And eventually I became very involved with the theater company, and that was something I did all throughout my years of high school. So when you're thinking about any new experiences or you're scared to try something new, don't worry about failing. It's not always gonna work out how you planned. Things aren't always gonna, you know, go exactly what you wanted them to, but that's not always a bad thing. Although I didn't end up getting the part, I didn't get to be the play, that led me to be involved with the art crew. I became the house manager for the theater company and eventually on the keyboard as the production manager, which was a really huge accomplishment for me. And honestly, you'll never know what's out there, what's in store for you, unless you go and take that step and take that risk. If I had never gone to that first audition, which I was extremely nervous for, I never would have met all these people and had all these amazing experiences throughout high school. So I know this may be hard to believe because I'm 5 foot nothing, but I did play lacrosse in high school for a couple years. So this is something that I knew nothing about entering high school. Our town didn't have any rec lacrosse teams or anything, so I literally didn't know how the sport worked. I didn't know what you're supposed to do with the stick, like what goes on with the sport. But a few of my friends told me about it, and there was a clinic at the YMCA that the coach was hosting, so I decided, you know, why not? What do I have to lose here? This is just something I know nothing about. All that I'm going to get gained from this is that I'll learn how to play the sport. I may not be good, but at least I'll have a good time. So I decided to do the clinic at the Y over my winter break. Started to learn how to play the sport, and I was like, hey, this is pretty cool. I'm doing this with my friends, and I'm having a good time. Come March, there were tryouts at school for the lacrosse team. And a lot of my friends were thinking about doing it, and I figured, again, why not? What do I have to lose from taking this risk? If I don't make the team, whatever, you know? I wasn't planning on doing this originally, but it'll be a cool experience. So somehow, come March, I tried out, and I actually made the team. And this was such an amazing experience for me. Just by starting out and taking those small steps and doing the clinic with my friends, going to tryouts, I became a part of something so much bigger that I never experienced. Before high school, the only sport I ever played was tennis, and that's so different from playing a team sport like lacrosse. So it was a whole new environment for me, and by taking little risks and little steps, I was able to gain experiences that I never would have had before. The next big thing in my life, and the biggest risk I took, was going to Rutgers. Now, I'd never been away from home before, and although I'm still not that far, this was the first time that I was independent, I was living in a dorm, and I had no one really there to tell me what I had to do or where I had to go. There was no one guiding me, like, okay, you have to take these classes, have to, you know, join these clubs, do all these things. This was the first time where I was kind of open to so many different opportunities, but kind of without a roadmap to guide me where to go. So this was definitely really scary for me, although I figured, hey, this is a new opportunity, and I want to take advantage of it. So also I had to take a lot of initiative to kind of push myself and do things that I wanted, because I think we can all realize that coming to a school like Rutgers, it's extremely overwhelming when you're surrounded by thousands of other students, and there's also so many different ways to get involved that it can be really intimidating and overwhelming. So,
try not to use sub as your transition point.
One of the main things that I've learned is you shouldn't let your fear hold you back. One of my biggest fears once I came into college as a sophomore in the business school was networking, and that freaked me out. I didn't know what to do or what to say to people, and I just had no idea what the concept was about. But what eventually I had to do was kind of step outside of that zone again and figure out what to do next. Now, this comes into play when I was thinking about joining a fraternity, Kappa Theta. When I was a sophomore in my fall semester, I was thinking about doing something new. I wanted to join a business fraternity, but I had no idea what they were about. A friend of mine told me about it, and I decided, okay, let's go check it out. Like I said, my biggest fear was networking, and that's exactly what the first event was. I had to go out there and talk to a bunch of people I didn't know, and I had no clue what to say to them. But going through with that, initially, although it may have been a little bit awkward, I was able to meet a lot of people, and I gained a lot of friends that I never had before and wouldn't have had if I didn't take that chance. Looking back, if you think about that question again, what's the bigger risk? Taking the risk or not taking the risk? Now, I kind of want to pose an answer to that question with another question. Well, hold on. Before that, I just want to let you know, when you're thinking about trying new things in your life, or if you're scared to do anything different, just know that you'll never, you never know where you're going to go next, but if you just stand still, you're never going to get anywhere. Basically, whenever there's a new opportunity, you just need to know that you don't really have much to lose. You either take the risk and go for it and get something great, or you fail and you get a life lesson, and you can always take that to go on and do greater things in your life. Now, when you're thinking about a new opportunity, think about what you'll accomplish by not taking the risk, and what will you accomplish by taking the risk, even if you fail. When there is a new opportunity, when there's something new you want to try, there's anything you want to go for, you really need to think about the worst thing that could happen. I know that's a scary thought. We don't want to think about the bad things. But if you really stop and think, the worst thing that could happen is just failing. You're not going to lose much except for you put yourself out there, you made yourself maybe a little bit vulnerable, but you did learn something from the experience, and ultimately that's what's going to help you moving forward and possibly leading you to better, bigger and better opportunities.